In this video, we're going to look at and review some React code like a senior React developer. The project that we're going to be looking at today is a great project, but it has a couple of things that I see a lot of developers get wrong in their own React applications. And my goal for this video is to really show you how I would approach reviewing code like this if this was a real code review, and also to give you an insight to the things that I'm thinking about whenever I look at React code or even code my own React applications. Hopefully, by the end of this video, you will have learned a couple of lessons that you can immediately go and apply to your own React projects and become a better React developer. So get comfortable, grab some popcorn if you want, and enjoy the show. And really try to absorb as much as you can from this video, because you're not going to be able to find the things that I'm talking about anywhere else. Let's get into it. This is the application that we're going to be looking at today. It's called Chatly, and it's essentially a simple social media platform. You have posts, you can create posts, you can then like your post, comment on your post, delete the post or edit the post. And here, if I go on the actual post page, we have all of the comments of that post. I can create a new comment, like it, edit it, delete it, and also leave a reply if I want to. For this video, we're only going to be looking at this page right here. This is the page of a single post. In the code, there's enough interesting things in this page that is going to make for a great video. So let's look at the code and see what's so interesting about it. This is the post page component. So you have it here, and this is a page component, right? So as a page component, this component is responsible for taking all of the different pieces of code across the app, putting them together and rendering the actual page that we saw, the page of a single post. So here we have these first three lines of code, which each tries to access a different context that is available in the app. So we have the use single post context, which gives you access to a single post that we have as current post. Then we also have the use auth context, which gives you access to the current user. And then you have this use main context here, which gives you access to set open modal and then set selected comment. If I go to the definition of use main context, you're going to see that this is a pretty big context that tries to do a lot of different things. So we have here the main provider, and just right off the bat, looking at this, we have a bunch of different things going on. We have some state for the posts. We have some state for the modal. We have some state for the selected post and the selected comment. And then we have some error and loading states, which is not really clear what they're relating to, like what is loading and what is this error. And then we're also using the use single post context and the use auth context inside of here. So already you can get a feel that this is a bit confusing and that this is trying to do a little bit too many things, right? I'm not entirely sure if all of these things here have to be in this provider. What I would do, just looking at this code here, I would create separate providers for the different things that are related to one another. For example, I might create one provider for just posts and then maybe put the selected post in there because it's also related to a post. Or maybe I'm wrong and the selected post actually goes with the selected comment and these two should have their own provider. Regardless of which way it is, it should definitely be a separate provider. Then I would also have a different provider for the modal because the modal has nothing to do with the post, has nothing to do with comments, and is kind of its own separate thing. So that deserves a custom provider. Also, there's another thing here that is interesting, and I'm not really sure if this is the best way to do things. So we have this piece of code here, this effect right here, that essentially fetches all of the posts. So we're basically setting all of the posts from the response in the post state. This is also, by the way, where we're using the loading and error states. So that's what they relate to. The thing is, however, we're using this context, we're using this fetch post, which basically fetches it on mount. We're using it in the post page component, which should be for a single post, not for all of the posts. Why are we fetching all of the posts in the post page component? That doesn't really make any sense. Maybe there actually is a reason, and I'm just not aware of it because I haven't looked at the whole code, but the fact that we're not accessing the post when we're using this main context here tells me that we're not actually using the post in this component, yet they are still being fetched inside of this provider. Then we have this function here that allows you to create or delete a comment like. This is going to be used in this function here, handle like on comment. Then we have some state that allows you to edit a comment and also add a comment reply. And finally, we're using the navigate function from React Router. The really interesting part of this component is this function right here, the handle like on comment. This is a function that will either create a comment like on a comment or delete that same comment like if the comment is already liked. So let's look at the code of this function, and I want you to pay attention because this is really interesting and there's a lot to learn here. So the first thing that we're doing is if we don't have a comment, or if we don't have a current post, or the current post doesn't have comments, we're just doing an early return. Then we're getting the index of the comment to add a like to, or to delete a like to, from currentPost.comments. Remember, current post is coming from here, use single post context. We're looking at all of the comments of current posts, we're doing find index on it to get the index of the comment that we're trying to update. Then over here, we're checking if the comment is already liked by looking at the comment.likes and try to find some of those likes that have the user's username within it. If the comment is not liked, then we're going to create here a post request to essentially create a new comment like, give it the comment ID and the current post ID and a post request. Then over here, we're checking the response, and if the response is not 200, we're doing an early return. Here, I would have loved to see some error handling to show something to the user in case something went wrong with this request right here, because things can go wrong and this response status is not always going to be 200. And then over here, all of this code is actually going to create this comment like. And here, I want you to pay attention because there's a lot of lessons to learn. So the first thing that we're doing is we have this new likes variable here, which is taking the comment.likes, it's spreading them, and then adding the user.username. This is perfectly fine, and this is what I would also do if I wanted to create a new comment like. Then over here, we're getting all of the comments of the current post, and then we're assigning it to this updated comments variable. And then using the index, which remember we got here at the top using this piece of code here, we're updating that comment, that one specific comment, by the index, and we're sending its likes to the new likes. And then to actually make the update that we now have a new comment like, we're actually setting the current post and we're updating the post with its comments to the updated comments. So to create a new comment like, we're doing three steps. We're first creating the comment like, then we're updating all of the comments of that current post, and then we're updating the current post with the new comments that has the new like within it. This is too many steps to just add one like on a single comment. You shouldn't have to use the current post and then access all of its comments just to add a new like on one single comment. And the problem here comes from the fact that the comments are stored on the current post and not separately. This is actually inefficient because every time you load the post, you also have to load all of its comments. And if the post has a lot of comments, you're going to bloat all of the state, all of the memory of the application by keeping everything in there. And then when you want to make an update to one comment to add a new like, you have to go through all of the comments of the current post, find the comment, and then actually make the like there. This is inefficient. And then if you look here, we're also doing the same thing if the comment is already liked. The only difference is that instead of sending a post request, we're sending a delete request to actually delete the like on that comment. But this code here is pretty much the same thing. To really understand why the post and the comments should be separate things and stored separately, let's look once again at this actual page. This is the part that we're concerned with, clicking this button here. If I click it, it's going to add one like. If I click it again, it's going to remove that like. If you look at this page, this has two sections. We have the top part here, which is only related to that post. We see all of the post details, who it was posted by, its title and body, and then all of these buttons here. And then we have the second section, which is only related to the comments of that specific post. But the actual entity, the database entity that this part relates to, is a comment and not a post. And so ideally, this should be a separate component that fetches the comments separately and then manages its own state separately aside from the post. This post component here should be its own component and only have things that are related to the post. Even if these are the comments of that specific post, they shouldn't be held together in the same state. They should be separate. And if you actually look at the JSX of this component, the author of this code actually had the right intention and did create a post component for that specific post. This is it right here. If I comment this code out and I go back to the application, you see that the top part is gone. That was that component, right? This is a post component. If I go to its definition, you see that here it receives a post from props, and then it has all of the code to essentially do things on that post. This is correct. But if we go back to post page, the same wasn't done for the comment section. We have this comment section here, which yes, has its own style component, but it's not actually a real component. This is all of the code for the comment section all the way until here. but this is in the post page component. This should have been a separate component with its own state that can manage its own functions. Now, I can only assume why this was only done for the post and not for the comment section, but probably this has something to do with the fact that the comments are stored on the post, and so it didn't make logical sense, or it wasn't really obvious that this should be its own component, but it should. So now let me show you how I would approach this if I was the one writing this code. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come here and I'm going to create a new component, and I'm going to call this one postcomments.tsx. And here we're going to create a new component. So we're going to do rjsfc, and then I'm going to call this postcomments. And here for the body, we're just going to return nothing for now. Now, the only thing that this component will need from the parent, because it will be placed here inside of this post page component, is the actual ID of the post. We're going to use this ID of the post to actually fetch its comments, store them in a separate state, in the state of this component right here. And then we have decoupled the comments from the post, even if they are related by their post ID. So we'll come here at the top. We're going to do type post comment props, and here we're going to do post ID, and that I think should be a string. Let's hope that it is a string. And then here we're going to do post ID, and that's going to be post comment props. Then this component should have its own state for the comments, so we can create that. We can do const comments set comments equals use state, import this from React, and let Copilot be almost super helpful. We're going to import iComment, which I think is available in this project, and then we're going to instantiate this with an empty array. Then using that, we can actually create a use effect here. So we'll do use effect, and then we're going to do this. We're going to create the dependency array, and then we're just going to fetch comments. I'm not actually going to implement it because I don't want to do the whole thing about fetching comments. I just want to show you the logic and how I would approach this if I was designing how these components should actually be architected. Next up, I'm going to create another component, and this component is going to be for a single comment. So I'm going to come here, make a new file, and I'm going to do post comment card.tsx. Again, we're going to do the same thing, rjsfc post comment card. And here we're going to do empty for now. This component will have to receive a comment through props. So let's give it a type. Let's do type post comment card props equals, and here we're going to do comment I comment just like so. Then import the comment, make some space, and then define the props over here, comment, and then post comment card props. So this component receives a comment in its props, and then we'll do things with that comment. Then back to the post comments component, where we actually have all of these comments here. What we can do is we can come here, make a new line, and we can map over all of the comments. So we can do comments.mapComment, and then let's see, we're going to return comment, actually post comment card, and then give it a comment here, and then just close this out like so. And there we go. And now we just need to give this also a key. So that's going to be key equals comment dot ID, like so. So now what we have is we have a post comments component, which receives a post ID from the parent. It then will fetch its own comments using this use effect here, store them in here. And then for every single comment, it will map over them and render the post comment card component. The post comment card component will receive a comment through props. And here's where we can do all of our functionality, like creating a comment like. So for example, I'm going to take this function right here, copy all of this code. We're going to put this over here, and we're going to do this, and then just close it like here, and then put a comment implement. Now, because we have a comment here from props, we actually don't need to have this over here. And we can just have this simple function like so that will just like a single comment or delete the like if it's already liked. We can also access here const user equals use auth context, I believe. And there we go. And now using this user, we can actually define a variable here. We can do const is liked equals, and then comment likes dot sum. And we have the same code as we had before. However, because comment.likes is an array, I don't want to run this on every render. So I'm actually going to memoize this entire function. So we're going to do here, use memo, and then we're going to do a function, and we're going to paste all of this here and then provide the dependency. Let's see. There we go. Now we have isLiked, which is only used once or whenever comment.likes changes or the user's username change, and we can use it inside of this function here. Then, to actually add a like to a comment, we have two options. We can either send this directly to the backend and wait for the backend to respond and then update the UI, or we can do things optimistically and update the UI before sending it to the backend and just assume and hope that the backend will return a 200 response. So for example, if we wanted to do optimistic updates, we would come here, we would make a new state variable, const local comment, and then set local comment. And then we're going to create a state variable here, and we're going to import useState from React, and then we're going to default this to the comment. This is going to allow us to have a different variable, a local variable of the comment that we can update as state and then not have to wait for the backend to update this comment property here. This is something that I do in a lot of applications where I want to have optimistic updates, because then we can actually come here and we can do something like do if, and then if is not liked, then we can actually do const new likes equals, and let's see, can Copilot do it? There we go. We're getting the likes of the local comment and we're adding the user.username there. And then we can come here and we can do set local comment and then update the comment with the new likes. We no longer need to have the current post to make this update. Everything is managed within this one component and it makes things a lot simpler. Now, obviously, you would also have to send this to the backend, right? So we're going to put your send this to backend because you do actually have to make the update in the backend. But then whenever you reload the actual page, it's going to reload this component. This local comment here is going to get reinitialized with the updated comment, which has is liked from the database. And then remove the like on the comment if you want, still send it to the backend via this code here, which we haven't implemented, but also at the same time have optimistic updates and get instant feedback to the user, which is always a good thing. Right, so already you can see that this component is a lot simpler, this looks a lot easier to manage and a lot less confusing. And this is all because we separated things into separate components and each has its own responsibility. In this component, the post comment card, we would also put all of the code related to actually editing a comment and perhaps also the comment reply. Although I would argue that this should be its own component, but at least for the editing, you can have that state here in this component. And then if we set it to true via one of the buttons, which will be in this component, you can then render the post comment card edit component and do your edits there. And then all of the functionality for that would be in that component and not in this one. This is a much better design pattern for your React components instead of putting everything in one component and trying to do everything there. As we've seen, this is something that can get really messy, very confusing, and also unperformant, and I would not recommend that you do this in your own React applications. A general rule of thumb, if I can give you some advice, is that whenever you're looking at a React page that has a lot of different sections that relate to different entities, all of these different sections should be different components that manage their own state and maybe fetch their own data. And then all of the code related to doing that, to fetching the data, to making updates, should go in those components and not in the main big page component. As I've said in the beginning of the video and in other videos as well, a page component should only have one responsibility, which is to take all of the different pieces of code across the app and put them together in such a way that it can render its content. So that means taking this post component here, that means taking the post comments component here for a different section and not implementing all of that code inside of its own body like is done here. This is not something that, once again, I recommend that you do. Instead, do this, create a custom component, and your life will be a lot better. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos just like these, make sure to leave this video a big thumbs up. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really gonna enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Cousin. This is Cousin Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.